Hello, everybody. I'm Crystal Hughes, and welcome to At Home with NCWLIFE, your local resource for all things home and real estate. Today, we will be visiting with real estate agent Lisa Boyle at Leavenworth, but first, your weekly market update. In the last year, many people have reevaluated what home really means. According to Keeping Current Matters, a real estate resource, those who own their home have awarded annually, averaging about $17,000 individually and $1 trillion nationally. This gain in home equity is a blessing for homeowners in these trying times. And it seems that the next 2 years will continue to reward those who do own a home. Washington and California have had the most significant amount of equity gains year over year, with Washington at the highest at 36,000 and California close behind at 34. While 2020 has faced its fair share of ups and downs, we know one thing to be true, that the real estate market locally and nationally not only met expert predictions, it surpassed them, breaking records along the way. With that in mind, there's one big blaring question right now. Will the housing market in 2021 follow the same trajectory, or are we facing a possible downturn? There are three reasons to be optimistic about real estate in 2021, in my expert opinion. In the latest projections from Freddie Mac, interest rates for a 30-year fixed rate mortgage are expected to remain at or near 3% next year. More homeowners have over 50% in equity, and they're able to invest the equity or cash out and purchase another home, keeping the market moving and the demand high. Third reason, reports are showing a large influx of relocation buyers from all over the U.S. and largely from high-tech areas like Seattle and the east side of the mountains. Cash buyers are moving to more rural locations like ours to enjoy the benefits of the beautiful scenery, the lifestyle, and the access to internet with a vacation-like feel. After the holidays, historically and annually, around the middle of January, we typically see more homes come available, and of course, more will come available in the spring. We do anticipate that Fannie Mae and Freddie Mae have said, and Zillow have said, around a 5.5% to 7% increase by spring. In our Wenatchee market, total sales are actually down 15% from November in 2019, while closed sales year to date are up 3% from this same time. Folks, that just means there's just not enough inventory and the demand is so high. So when people say it's expensive to buy here, it's all relative. It's getting more and more expensive the longer the people wait. New listings are down about 13% from this time last year. Pending transactions for the month of November were closely around 108 listings. They were down about 30% from October and about 57% down from November of 2019. So we have about half of the amount of listings available than there were last year. This last week, I wrote 4 offers, and one of the offers that I wrote was for over $100,000 over the asking price. Someone paid cash, beat us out, and they paid more than $100,000 for the house. Year-to-date, median sales price is up by 6%, and the average sales price is up total by a total of 10%. The heaviest sales activities during the last 6 months continues to be about $300,000 to $4,000 in that price range. Here's what we know. If you're thinking of spending $200,000 to $300,000 in our market, understand that you're maybe going to be investing, maybe fixing something up, and or maybe purchasing a condo. A 2-bedroom condominium unit with a view and a bathroom, or maybe two, is around $1,750 a month to rent. So with that, if you can get a mortgage for a $250,000 condo with a mortgage with about a 5% down payment, your monthly payment's only around $1,500 a month. That's a fantastic monthly payment, and you're cash flowing at that point. In today's market, it's really important that you understand exactly what your options are, that you have a trusted team and network to help you make your financial decisions, especially going into 2021. 2020 is almost behind us, folks, but keeping in mind that there were a lot of positive things despite some of the negative things happening in our market. And that is your weekly market update.
Winter is a great time to trade in your current hot tub. Turn your old hot tub into money with Blue Lagoon Pool and Spa's trade-in program. You can save $500 to $1,000 off of any new Artesian spa or take advantage of a free Bluetooth music experience. Blue Lagoon Pool and Spa recommends draining your hot tub every 3 months. Ask us about our drain and refill special. Stop on by Blue Lagoon Pool and Spa today.
Welcome back. We're here today with real estate agent Lisa Boyle with Keller Williams. Thank you so much for being here with us today.
Thank you so much for having me, Crystal. I'm excited.
Yes, absolutely. Well, I have just loved seeing you come into the industry and just absolutely do so well. I just love your energy and your passion. And you've been in the industry for just a short 2 years. However, you've done more business than some agents have done in their lifetime. So super, super impressive, girl. So tell us a little bit about yourself and what led you to become a real estate agent and all of your success that you've had so far.
Well, there's a lot that goes into that as far as to why I chose this as a career path and I guess lifestyle. And I'd say that my biggest decision is that I love working with people, very people oriented. I love watching people succeed and helping them out. My mother-in-law has been a real estate broker in California for over 20 years, and watching her go on vacation but still work, and the freedom she had while still the connection she was making, it enticed me. So I thought maybe I can do that as well, and jumped right into it and found my passion.
So I love it. So not only are you a single family home, you do not just on buy and sale side, but you do new construction. I know you help people with rentals and Airbnb. So talk a little bit about kind of what you do, the day in the life for you looks like, and where your business is headed and comes from.
A lot of the business does come from word of mouth. You know, it takes just one person and giving them the attention they deserve and the follow-up that they deserve. And that person can lead to so many other people. You know, you do your job and you do it well and you truly care about your clients, that eventually is going to get out there, which is what is happening with me. And it doesn't matter whether it was my first sale or it's now my 100th. You know, people matter, and getting them into the right house, whether it's new construction or a piece of land or a commercial property, it is about helping people and listening to their need. At the end of the day, everybody just wants to be heard.
Oh, I love that. It's so true. Everybody just wants to be heard and connected with, right? And I always say that it's less about homes and more about people. It really is.
Yes.
You know, being an expert in the field, but also helping them through the process. And you're so good at that. I know we've had several transactions together, and it's always fun and a pleasure to work with you. So you're a Leavenworth local. You do a lot of real estate. Now I know you service the whole area, not just Leavenworth, but you know, with that specialty and that beautiful niche of everyone wanting to move there, you know, so talk about, you know, people coming from all over the world. How do you differ and provide services from some of the agents who I know have been there and worked there for a very long time, or maybe even new in trying to break into the market and you having such success? Talk about kind of the difference in what you provide.
Well, as somebody once pointed out, it's called the big FU of real estate, and that is follow-up. So once again, and I might sound like I'm on repeat, but it really is about follow-up. And I can't tell you how many phone calls I received that said, hey, I was speaking to so-and-so, but now they're not responding to my text messages or my emails, and can you help me out? Absolutely. Yeah. Yep. It just, yes, answer your phone, answer your text messages. If you have nothing new to say or no information to provide, you can actually, we are all human beings and we're all interacting together, and I have no problem telling somebody, I have no idea, but let me find out. And then I do that.
Yeah, communication is key, right? So being there for people, like you said, following up and ensuring that they understand exactly where you're at in the process. And, you know, you really, I know that you lean in and you study a lot, and you're an expert in the field of rentals and Airbnbs. There's a lot of stuff going on right now with the county and the cities and moratoriums statewide. So I know that's a little bit of a touchy subject, but to my point is that it's really important that you hire an expert and someone who knows what they're doing and what they're talking about. And like you said, will answer their phone to make sure that, you know, your buyers and sellers are taken care of, right? It's simple, but not.
Yeah, it is. And you're right. Chelan County does have, and not to get into all the controversy of it, but there is some big changes maybe happening, and there is a moratorium that could potentially stop nightly rentals. People need to be informed on that. You know, that's a huge decision, and you could devastate somebody's life by having them purchase something that they think that they're going to use for one thing and are unable to. So having someone that is up to date in the market and the regulations from town to town, knowing the industry and the location is what you need, because these are not, you know, real estate is a major purchase. Regardless of the dollar amount, it's an investment, and you need somebody that will provide the right investment for you. So,
absolutely.
Or help you.
Absolutely. So with that, in your expert opinion, then, you know, you're growing up there from the inside out. Why do you feel that the demand has drove the price 25% increase in the last year? You know, with the way that we're in with COVID today and what everyone wants to see.
Demand, location, and if we're talking Leavenworth specifically, the town itself keeps growing and we keep adding new businesses, which in return is making it even more desirable than it was even 20 years ago. I grew up here and none of the shops, everything that you're seeing today didn't exist 20 years ago. So the more that the town is succeeding, the more that people are wanting to be a part of it and invest here. And now with COVID, you can work anywhere. Everybody is working remotely. So what's to say that you're stuck in the West Side or you're stuck in a different state? You can now virtually work wherever you want to work and you can live wherever you want to live. So we've got a higher demand.
The view matters, right? The view matters. What you see now more than ever, especially with COVID, having to be at home, the view matters. So you can live in a beautiful rural place like Leavenworth and have a beautiful view and still have access to the internet and do your job, like you said. That's wonderful.
Exactly.
That's a huge demand for the drive. So we'll be right back after a quick commercial break.
Homeward bound. I wish I was homeward bound. Home, where my life thoughts are escaping. Home, where my music's playing. Home, where my love lies with.
Silently for me.
Welcome back. We're here visiting with Lisa Boyle with Keller Williams Real Estate Agent, mainly working out of Leavenworth and Wenatchee and Cashmere, surrounding Lake Chelan area. Thank you again so much for being here.
Yeah, thank you again for having me.
Yes. So the million-dollar question, right, that everyone keeps asking, and you hear it constantly, is what do you think the market is going to do in 2021? Right, we don't have a crystal ball, but from your expert opinion and what you see, how do you anticipate inventory and demand for going this next year?
You know, it has been a rough year with a lot of changes in 2020, but fortunately, it did not actually affect the market, the housing market, as everybody thought it would. And I, like you said, do not have a crystal ball, but I don't see it slowing down in 2021. In fact, if we continue to work remotely and have the ability to live wherever we want to live, I believe there is going to be, a flurry of purchases and sales and homes to choose from. And I think if anything, it's just going to continue upward.
I agree. You know, and what's fascinating, you and I are about around about the same age. And one of the statistics that I saw that I found was really, really empowering was that single millennial age women made up about 35% of the people that purchased in this last year. So there's a lot of positives, you know, with all the equity and the gain in this last year that's going to happen that we can look at and say, okay, where are those people going to go next year? How are they going to continue to build equity and continue to, right, and grow and improve and build their wealth? And who's going to be doing that, right? So in your experience, how has this then affected our real estate community locally? Like, where do you think that positively and I mean, small businesses have been affected, right? But where do you foresee this going in the next year with, you know, interest rates and pricing? Do you think it'll go up? Do you think, you know, a lot of people will say, oh, there might be a market crash? Like, what's your expert opinion on all of that?
Well, and it's just my opinion, but, and, you know, watching the market is, I do not predict a crash. I don't see that happening. Now, do I think that prices are going to continue to increase as dramatically and quickly as far as value increase as they did? Maybe we might see a slight plateau as far as the prices go for selling a home. Maybe it will become a little bit more affordable, but if it wouldn't be a drop. I see maybe a plateau with or a more gradual rise and not as quickly and dramatic as it has been in the past.
Yeah, there's a few different resources out there. What I'm reading, like Zillow says maybe a 7% increase next year. Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac are saying 5. Interview that I'm doing for next week, she said anticipating of 6. So it's really interesting to just kind of see where the market will go and possibly through 2022. A lot of the top economic, you know, forecasts are saying that we will continue to grow. And so for that, that is good news for people who are sitting at home watching, wondering, should I wait? Should I sell? Should, you know, do I buy and sell now? You know, that's always the question is, you know, what's the market doing? Well, I think it's always individual, right, Lisa? Like, you know that, like it's always about talking with people and finding out, is it important for you right now? Well, let's break it down, you know, individually per person. So, you know, so if someone right now, right, they're sitting at home, they're watching this, and maybe they're, you know, they're obviously on the edge of their seat, they're ready to call you because they're like, that lady knows what she's talking about and I want the opportunity to invest, right? So if they have questions in real estate, maybe they're just on the fence or they're scared. Maybe they think that it's not even possible, debt, et cetera. What do they need to know? What is really most important for them to know in today's market?
A conversation costs you nothing. Pick up the phone, give me a call, shoot me an email, set an appointment. It doesn't cost you a dime to just speak with someone such as myself, a professional in the market that knows what they're doing. Just have a conversation, completely free, and gives you a better understanding, and it gets you out of that teeter-totter fence area of what is my home worth? Should I invest in this type of real estate? What's my next move? Because I can clear up a lot of questions for you and also help put you at ease, hopefully, and make it more exciting than stressful.
Well, I always love visiting with you about the real estate market and about where you're going and where you think things are headed. And I think that for me personally, I want to know, and I know the audience wants to know, what is the one thing, piece of advice that you want us to know about real estate today?
It's not as scary or overwhelming that you probably are thinking that it is. You don't get scared or amped up if you're thinking of buying a new car. You go to the dealership, you take a look at your options, and hopefully drive home with something that's more suitable than what you're currently in. House shopping or listing your house does not have to be any different. If you're in the right hands and you have somebody that knows the material, knows the product, knows what you are wanting, then it's a fun process, you know, everybody wins. It's just having the right knowledgeable person by your side, guiding you through it. And it results in just a happy ever after.
Well, I love your business model. I love your systems. I think that's really important for people who are sitting at home to know and watching that it really matters about the tools that the agents have, the expertise, and, you know, of course, their passion and drive to answer the phone and follow up, right? So I love it. Thank you again, Lisa. I look forward to working with you on another deal. You have been watching At Home with NCW Life. We'll be right back.
Mary Maids of Wenatchee has been professionally cleaning and sanitizing homes and businesses in North Central Washington since 1998. Mary Maids uses commercial grade cleaners and viricides. Mary Maids has implemented additional safety and sanitation protocols. They are strictly following CDC guidelines for the safety of their clients and employees. For expert help with cleaning and sanitizing your home or business, call or look up Mary Maids of Wenatchee to schedule your free estimate today.
And I want to talk to you about your winter landscape. You know, we have lots more rain than we do snow, it seems sometimes. And so de-icers are really important. And there's all sorts of things about de-icers, and people use bird seed and they use fertilizer and they use cat litter. All these things are just a nuisance, especially fertilizer, because it dissolves in the rain, and then it washes into the groundwater. So we do not want that, for sure. You need to buy a de-icer which has CMA in it, and that's calcium magnesium acetate. And it's on the bag, and they're a little bit more expensive, but that is the one that will protect your landscape from being burned. So it's important not to have your edges of your lawn burned, or the other thing. The other problems that we have at this time of year is compaction. If you drive on your lawn or park extra vehicles on the lawn, or even have a 80-pound dog running around on the lawn, you are going to have compaction. And that can cause problems with in the spring, where it'll have to be aerated. And just being aware of the fact, stay off the lawn as much as possible. The other problem that many people have is they have a gutter system in which the water comes down directly into a flower bed. I mean, the fact that it might flood your basement is one problem, but the other thing is that it super saturates all of that soil, and if you have bulbs there or perennials in that bed, they will be drowned. Their roots will be drowned. So there are lots of little plastic things that you can buy that extend the water out into the lawn or into an area where it is sloped. And that will take care of your yard.
Coming up next week, we'll visit with Coldwell Banker, Cascade and Wenatchee's managing broker and real estate agent, Joanna Holland. You've been watching At Home with NCW Life. I'm Crystal Hughes. We'll see you next week.